I'm here with Coach PR, DJ Caesar, Weekend Work, Joseph Sikora, Tommy from Power. Check yourself.
Oh. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about, man. 888-742-3345. It's Weekend Work.
I just come from the poorest part.
That's a hit record.
Yeah. That should have been
a hit record. That's a hit record, babe.
He's heard that. Yeah, you know who that is in the background there, Caesar?
Shit, I don't know.
Joseph Sikora. Did I say it right?
Yeah, you did.
Did I say it right? Yeah. A.K.A. Tommy. Damn. Black hand clap.
Tommy.
There it is.
Power's in the building.
I said it right, right? I said the last name right?
Sikora. Yeah.
Okay.
Joseph Sikora.
Italian?
Sikora. It's Polish.
Polish. Okay. Polish. Okay. Cool, man. Are you born in New York? Or you from Chicago, right?
Yeah.
Chicago.
Born and raised.
Born and raised in Chicago. Now, I'm happy to have you here, bro.
Yo, happy to be here.
I've been calling Gene in the office like, yo, can we get Tommy? Right, Jinx?
We need Tommy.
I said, yo, need Tommy. Let me get Tommy up here first.
Tommy, because I must say, though, before we get into your shit,
yeah,
I hate the person that you're dating on the show. She does a great job of making me hate her. Your girl?
Oh, man.
Yeah.
That's what I get the biggest complaint. They're like, that pillow talk has got to go.
Yeah.
I hate her.
Yeah.
What can you do? The boy's in love.
Boy's in love, son. Yo,
and it fits perfect for today, Crazy Bitch Saturday.
Yes.
Right?
That's Crazy Bitch Saturday. I brought that in with me.
Yeah.
I came equipped for Crazy Bitch Saturday.
You perfect, man.
Perfect.
Like, have you dealt with a female like that in real life?
Definitely.
Yeah?
Yeah, dated her for years.
Really?
Give us a quick story.
Crazy Bitch Saturday story.
I wrestled my key to my car out of her. She caught me leaving and trying to get away, to move out.
Mm-hmm.
And she heard me just kind of creeping. She jumped out of the shower naked and wrestled my key from my hand, ran out into the backyard and just tossed it in somebody else's yard.
And you were moving out?
Yeah, I was trying to get out. Like,
while she was in the shower.
And she jumped out naked.
Jumped out naked, wrestled me to the ground, no joke. Got my car key out of my hand, ran outside, buck naked, tossed it in somebody else's yard.
So you never moved out, I guess.
Oh, I moved out. I found that key and got the fuck
out of there.
Right? Yeah.
That's crazy, son.
See, everybody got a little crazy. You get smart. He got the fuck out of there.
Definitely.
Mm-hmm. How long were you dating her before you decided, you know?
Oh, a nice on and off for 6 years.
For 6 years.
Damn.
I drove from L.A. to Chicago in 27 hours straight.
Just for that
sleep.
Crazy pussy?
I was like, I got to get out of here.
Oh, you're leaving her?
I'm leaving. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Wow. Now, what happened that made you want to skip out so damn fast, if you're allowed to say it? You know what I'm saying?
She was crazy.
She was just crazy.
There's a whole bunch of crazy shit.
Man, that was bubbling over crazy.
Yeah, was the pussy good?
Man, I don't even want to comment. I don't even want to think about that. It was poison.
So, let's go to Power now, man. Going into the second season.
Mm-hmm.
First season was
incredible.
Great, credible. Like, everybody enjoyed it. Now you go in the second season, like, what can we, like, look for?
What can we expect?
You know, because last leaving, we've seen that, you know, she thought you were ghost and everything like that, so.
And we also left with Kanan just getting out the joint.
Yes.
Right. Which is
50 Cent.
Yeah, and with Ghost, Omari Hardwick, saying that he's going to be the biggest
drug dealer in New York City.
Yeah, quite a large commitment. I know. I'll be the biggest goddamn drug dealer in New York City.
Yeah, he's ready to turn it up.
So, and Tommy being like, that sounds good to me.
Yeah, right. Yeah, because that's what you want.
Like, absolutely.
Right.
But we'll see where allegiances lie, because Kanan obviously is going to try to do his own manipulation. Ghost is a manipulator. Tommy's really one of the only honest characters on the show.
Right, you're straight very
loyal. Right.
And loyal. Very loyal. But where that loyalty gets pulled and stretched between Kanan, who brought him and Ghost up and into the game, and Tommy's very loyal to him.
Right.
And Ghost saying, like, you know, being smart enough to know there can only be one Highlander.
Right.
And see where all that goes. So it's gonna be pushing and pulling and tugging and twisting and behind people's backs and in front of people's faces.
It's crazy.
Yeah, it's gonna be dynamite. I mean, it's compared to season one, so much going on.
Yeah, a lot of things going on.
Oh, it's gonna be crack for everybody. After that first episode, they're gonna be like,
it's gonna be crazy.
Damn, what's happening next? Yeah. Oh yeah.
So that's June, right? June.
I mean, I can't say, but sometime around summertime. I mean, I can't say because I don't know.
Right.
Understood.
When you got called for the role, what did you think about at first?
I thought, oh, this would be great, but then I couldn't actually do it at first when the first rounds, when people are auditioning for the role, I couldn't do it.
Why not, though?
Because I had another job that I was doing at the time.
Which one? Banshee? Boardwalk Empire? This guy was all over the place.
Actually,
right?
I think it was during True Detective.
True Detective, right. You did True Detective.
And then and then I was getting married, so then I couldn't do the audition again. I was back in Chicago.
You didn't get married to that crazy girl, though.
No, oh, my God.
It's a new one. Yeah, okay. No. Yeah, you got married to your slide?
No, I got married to a girl out here from New York.
So. Okay.
You got caught up.
That's nice, yeah. And she's unbelievably beautiful and very down to earth.
Nice.
Okay.
Congrats.
Thank you. And so, but then when I mean, I loved it, but I thought that, hey, you know, this could be stereotypical. Like they could have like that one guy, and then you don't want to. It's a balance, you know. There's all those kind of dials that you want to go in, like, you know, how New York is he compared to like how hood is he?
Right.
And, like,
right.
Where's that genuineness? Because I mean, I know white guys from the hood in Chicago,
right?
And but white guys in the hood in New York, slightly different, similar stuff. But you bring your own background into the character, right. And then you calibrate what seems true, and then you just play it for real.
And you play it for real because the talk, like DJ Explicit, could, you know, vouch for this in the barbershop. It's like, why do you get a white dude to play a hood, come out the hood role? Like, but there was this one ignorant dude in the barbershop, James, but he didn't understand it because he never had a white friend. Mm-hmm. So to me, it was like, you sound stupid, bro. There's white dudes that from the hood that act like that.
Exactly.
Like, he didn't get it. Like, you know, like, people really act like that, come that live in the hood. Well, around black people. Like,
he didn't spend a whole lot of time in the Bronx then, because...
and that's where he's from.
That's crazy.
You know, it's funny, because a lot of the guy who's my dialect coach is actually from the South Bronx, Bobby McMurray. And he grew up in the projects in the South Bronx. So, I mean, it's very common. It's very typical. Now, in Chicago, you can go square miles without a white person,
right?
But in New York, I mean, it's different.
Right.
It is the you know, cultures and colors are so much closer in New York that, I mean, it all makes sense.
That people, I don't think people, you know, probably so dumb they think they're. Can't be a white dude that sells drugs and stuff like that being like that.
Well, also, I think it's socially responsible for Courtney Kemp Agbo, who our brilliant creator, who's like, you know what, you have to see a white person in this role.
Going on, Ghost. Meet Miguel Alvarez and his fiance Maria. Cruz was driving his route when this motherfucker jumped him, shot him in the head.
Cruz, so he got
the money, a whole day's paper.
We get it back.
No, he handed it off before Victor tracked him down. Wasn't enough to kill him. This greedy motherfucker stole Cruz's phone, led us right to his place, found him in bed with her. Moron thought he was home free, about to have a celebration. Fuck.
Why the fuck would you bring him here? It's open tonight. I got a full house upstairs.
I thought you'd want to teach this motherfucker a lesson.
And the girl?
He needed some persuasion to talk. What?
You know what I mean?
Switch it up, man.
Switch it up and say, like, you know what? And it's, you know, it's up to me to say, I got to play this for real, from the heart. It's got to come off true. Otherwise, it's going to ruin the show.
Right.
But also, it's to say, like, we're so used to, as Americans, to see a black, or a person of color, at least, in that role of this evil drug dealing guy who's a little bit, I mean, Tommy's a little off. I mean,
he's off.
When you saw him burning this guy, the most important thing to me wasn't wasn't necessarily like that this man is on fire, but that he didn't like his Scarface imitation.
Right. Yep.
You know what I mean?
So
it's like,
you know what?
I can't believe this. Like, who do you like? Like, he wants to have a conversation with this guy. He's burning.
Yeah.
And then he's surprised when this guy doesn't want to talk back.
Right.
I'm getting burnt.
Tommy is off, man.
Tommy's greatly off. He's greatly off.
He's off, but he's on. I mean, he's a real human being, and we get to live and grow with him.
Right.
We get to see a dude fall in love for the first time, too, which makes us cringe because we all know how stupid we acted when we fell in love with and all this crazy shit that I've been hearing on the radio.
It fits in, like, it fits in, man. Triple H, Shape 45 is the weekend work.
We got Tommy in here.
What's his name, though?
Joseph.
That's good enough for me.
AKA Tommy.
Yeah, Tommy.
And we're gonna go through. You did a lot of roles. We're gonna come back and talk about like a whole bunch of stuff that you did.
When you getting prepared for a role and all that, what kind of music do you play like to get yourself ready?
Well, Tommy was different. I mean, Tommy, I played a lot of. I had some Kells going on for Tommy. R. Kelly.
Some R.
Kelly.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought he was some Machine Gun Kelly.
I did a lot for the research for Tommy though. I based him a lot on Dutch Schultz. a lot of the, you know, research and Dutch Schultz from back in the day. But yeah, man, R. Kelly was definitely in the mix.
You didn't peel nobody in season two, then?
No.
Okay. Triple H 845. R. Kelly. Please tell me.
What's up?
Please tell me you don't listen to that record right there, though, before you go.
Oh, come on.
That one?
Come on, that's all right. I like that one.
That one too, Joe? Come on, Joe. Like, that one right there, Joe.
I
like,
told you, Joe.
I think that was R. Kelly's worst ever.
That shit got the hoes, man. Lacking Oreo. Get
Torch, it you like that too?
That's the shit, man.
Ah, Torch.
Nah, that was that bullshit.
Come on.
That was that good shit, man.
Yeah, your man Joe like it, though.
You never
like
licked it like an Oreo? Yeah, you did.
Yeah,
man.
Did.
Hey, man.
Yeah,
I got, look what I got over here.
Look at that. He's got some Oreos.
Cookies right there. Many Oreos and shit. So, you got a whole lot of stuff that you did, a lot of work that you did. Like, yeah, which one would role did you, besides Power, just because I know you're probably going to say Power or whatever.
Power.
Put out Power. Out of everything, which one did you really love doing? Like, from True Detective all the way back.
Oh, one of my favorites was Jack Reacher, actually, even though they cut out all my lines except for the last scene.
That's what we were talking about.
I was about to say, were you the guy in the bed?
Yeah, I was
shit?
The sniper, yeah. The guy got my ass kicked.
Right. Yeah.
And you said, call Jack, he'll fix this shit.
Yeah.
You shook.
I did. I was bad. I was really bad. That must have been awful. Yeah.
So you like that? That was what
I just, I made some great friends. Chris McQuarrie, who directed it and wrote it, he's become a good friend. And Jai Courtney is one of my best pals, too.
Okay.
So that was a great experience. And I love Tom Cruise. I mean, that guy is an incredible professional. I would work with that guy again in a second.
Tom Cruise,
he's awesome. Everything that people say about, I love that people love to hate on Tom Cruise. Because I don't get it.
Yeah.
He's like the nicest guy in the world.
Really?
He remembers everybody's name. He's a constant. If you don't bring your A game, I would be scared to be on that set.
Wow. Right. Okay.
But if you're there to work and have fun and make a movie, Tom Cruise is your best friend.
Okay. Yeah. He's with you.
What is your, if you haven't already worked in it, what is your dream role? The role that you got into acting for?
Good one.
Oh, man. Any role. I mean, I really am that character actor. I mean, I think I love all aspects of being a human being, so I really don't have that. I mean, Tommy's a dream role for me. I mean, I was a graffiti writer growing up, an urban kid, you know, a hip-hop head for a long time.
Right.
And I get to kind of live this life. I mean, everybody who grew up in the city has a bit of an anger issue that we're trying to fix as men.
Yeah, so now New York.
Yeah, now I get to act out and be like, you know, when I'm angry, I'm angry.
Right,
and Tommy's
right.
0 to 60, from 0 to 10 immediately.
Right.
And that's fun. So, I mean, Tommy's been a real dream role. But
so any role is good.
I love a million different kind of roles. It's really hard to kind of pin what I would do. I mean, I'd like to play James Bond. I want to be the first American James Bond.
Yo, U.S. James Bond?
Diddy wants that role, though. You know that, right?
Yeah, man. He'd be a great James Bond, too. But we'll have to see how his English accent is.
Yeah.
I don't know if I can see Diddy in James Bond.
That's what he wants. He wants that role, though.
I don't think I can see Diddy in it. But if I had, you know, I like you as James Bond. I also like my man Jason Statham.
Jason Statham.
He's ill.
For James Bond?
Yeah, I just like his tough movie. He always beating motherfuckers up.
I was in a movie with him. It was called Safe.
So I love Safe.
I was the Russian gangster guy.
Yes.
Holy shit. That's why you see how I gave you the alley-oop. Boom.
That's right.
There it is.
That's dope.
Yeah, you told me off air that you ran into Eli.
Oh, yeah. Eli at the SNL 40-year thing that 50 took me to was great. I mean, that room was every celebrity under the sun, which was crazy. But then just to have Eli be like, oh, no, I know who you are, and
he loves
love the
he
show.
Loves power,
yeah,
right?
It's like sick.
Eli Manning watches Power.
Yep.
That's dope.
I thought he was a Glee watcher. I'm serious. I couldn't see Eli Manning doing that, like watching Power, though.
Hey,
but
he's a dynamic human being. He probably likes them both.
So being from Chicago, this question, I don't know. I'm going to ask him the question.
Okay, go ahead.
The better duel, Kobe, Shaq, Jordan, Pippen. I don't know where he's going to go.
Well, Jordan Pippen, I mean, it's not even in the same league.
Ain't even the same league.
Well, a lot of people will argue that.
You don't think that's a conversation?
Of course it's a conversation, but it's a short one.
Thank you. You're talking about 6-for-6 in the championship, 72-10. What else can you talk about?
I mean, you just asked as a combination because who worked better together? I mean, really and truly, who worked better together?
Jordan Pippen.
So the other two is kind of two individuals that shined and then kind of worked together. I mean, maybe they had a better television show. but but a reality show. But
I'm with you 100% on that one.
Right.
But with Michael and Scotty. Scotty was just like, you know, hey, you know, he's like, where's my number two? And Scotty's like, I'm right here.
Yeah, exactly. Right. I'm robbing your back.
Yeah, and I'm cool with that.
Have you ever had any interaction with Mike or anything?
Yeah, I did. You know what's crazy? I did a McDonald's commercial when I was a little kid with Michael Jordan.
Get the fuck out of here.
You can get it on YouTube. You can Google or search on the YouTube Michael Jordan McDonald's commercial, and I'm one of the ones pop up. I got my cute little blonde hair.
Would it be like Mike?
You like 11?
Oh. No. And no, I was like, it is Michael Jordan.
Wow, okay. So you've been behind the camera for
a while. I worked security at a club called Le Passage in Chicago that Mike used to go to all the time. And so I would be on like the personal detail of making sure that the celebrities didn't get bothered. So
Now he has a stigma too. People always say Mike's an asshole. Now, can you talk about Mike in Mike's defense? Is he an asshole?
I'm from Chicago. I can't say a word.
Well, you can't talk bad about Mike.
I'm not going to.
He can't do that.
Yeah.
He can't say nothing.
Well, as Tommy, what was Tommy say about Mike?
That's a good one.
Tommy would say, "Who the fuck you think you're talking to?"
Yeah. Is Tommy? You gonna still be with playing time? You still gonna be with the same girlfriend, or is she gonna die?
I thought she
was gonna be dead, man.
I thought she might be dead already.
Yeah. Oh, man, she ain't gonna die, man.
Tell us something.
Ooh, I don't know. She got shot at the end of last season.
He's quick on his feet, right? He's good.
Quick on his feet, though, man. Triple H 845 with the weekend work. You want to talk to some of the people, Joe?
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, we're going to come right back and talk to the people. Holler at them.
What you want
to
hear, Joe?
Break me up with some EPMD.
Woo! He don't have that.
Let's do something.
You don't have that. Triple H 845 is the weekend work. Joseph Sikora, right?
Yes.
AKA Sikora. That's it?
We'll get it better when we come back.
Triple H 845, weekend work. Coach PR, DJCs, IG The Explicit, and Superstar Torch. We up here. Triple H 845. Ooh.
Well, that's heavy right
there. That's my favorite APMD record right here.
This one?
So what you saying? And then Rampage after that. This record was... Joe, you just... You had him go in right there.
Man, you were bouncing in your Jeep.
Yeah. Yes. Oh, that's what I was remembering. I had the tracker back then, too. Never forget. Boom, boom.
Shit hitting hard, son.
We getting ready to throw you under the bus, though, Joe.
You gotta give us some bars right there.
You gotta get some bars, man. You know, Joe, since you a hip-hop head, everything. Yeah. I know you got, like, 16. You got a hot 16.
Nah.
No, he said, nah. You don't like this beat? You want me to put on the breeze?
I love the beat. I know whose station this is. I'm not like laying myself out like that.
Do you never used to rap when you were younger, bro?
Yeah, of course I did. Everybody did.
What you used to say? How you used to rhyme? Let me hear your rhyme.
Oh, man, my rhyme style would have been so dating myself. I'd be like in 1989 style. Even from the beginning, I get paid in full because my rhymes on time and your mind is dull, so take a chance while I prance in my b-boy stance or get on the floor while I make you dance. I'm J4F, Shot Town representing. When I walk down the street, yo, it's like an event. People come up to me, they want my autograph. I get down on my knees like a golden calf. I wouldn't say I'm like a god, but I'm like a star. I smoke you like a cigarette and leave you with the tar. And when you want to come around to be my friend, I say your crime too much to make amends. You diss me, you diss yourself off the shelf, now you're broken. The rhyme has been spoken and it's golden molded. Steal is what you feel because I don't play around. You're just a punk that jumped up to get beat down. Woo, it's a round sound, and that means by the crew. Now that you're alone, what the fuck you gonna do? Too tough to believe when you're more than self deep, but you gotta farm right and only sow what you can reap. And you can't reap much now, can ya? You talk too much shit to understand ya. But keep watching me because you haven't seen this. I step to the system, I'm a microphone genius. Believe this.
Damn.
Because I teach it like a parable. Our rhymes are uncomparable. I'm fresh and you're terrible.
Terrible, nigga.
Terrible.
You're terrible.
Look, he said he didn't want to rap. We just got him.
Yeah.
Appreciate that, man.
Straight out of 89.
Go for it, Tommy. I don't remember the words.
I like it, she love it. No hesitation, I had to push up on it. I like it, she love it. No hesitation. Her breathtaking beauty had me gasping. Me and her together, this was simple math, and at least for me, it was destiny. Perfect recipe was me and baby girl.
Oh, come on, man. You know I hung my mic up a long time ago.
Ew, party pooper.
That's my husband.
Fine. If you ain't gonna rap, I need you to work a bit.
Get so much hate.
I'm like 79 if I rap. I'll really be showing my age, man. Power season 2, June, roughly around June, right?
Yeah, that sounds about right, I guess. Right.
What's your Instagram, Twitter? You got Instagram,
Twitter? Joseph Sikora 4. That's Josephsikora 4.
And that's on Twitter and Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
Both, right?
Yeah.
And you're married now, and you got girls calling you and everything. You still go through all that, you know, girls chasing you now. Tommy,
how's the groupie life, man?
How's the groupie?
Small. Not that much.
So, but you can't do nothing. You can just pass it to us?
Yeah. A little filter. It's like slipping the jab, and you'll be right behind
me. That's it, man, because you can't do that, man.
No, I wouldn't want to.
Who's going to win the fight, Pacquiao or Mayweather?
Can I say no comment?
Why?
I don't know, man. I feel like I shouldn't have one. I can't remember who's friends with who and who's on whose side of my boss is.
Mayweather 50 is cool again.
Who's Tommy going for?
Tommy would probably be going for Mayweather, so we can say that Joe wants Pacquiao.
Right, there you go. We appreciate you coming through, man.
Appreciate it, man.
Thank you guys so much. Great time.
My man.
Yes, sir. Joe Sikora, Power Season 2 coming this summer. Coach PR, DJ C, Superstar Torch, IDJ Explicit Behind the Lens, Triple H 845.
Everything I put together was all going in one night.
What if that bullet was meant for you? Can you think of anyone might want you dead?
We was brothers for life, but I can't trust him right now.
I gotta move forward in our marriage. Stop seeing Angela.
I'll handle it.
I can put Ghost in jail for the rest of his life.
If he'd have been dead when I got out like we planned, we'd been running the whole shit.
Look who it is! Welcome back, bro!
We want you back on the team.
Tommy, tell me anything I want to know. I'll play this fast. We have war with Ghost.
Ghost ain't been thinking too clearly.
I bet she knows everything about us.
The fuck's going on?
You made a deal to sell me out.
What?
Angela, a federal prosecutor, a goddamn United States attorney.
We're officially back to work.
You gotta make it work, so you will.
She says the wrong thing to the wrong person, she gets hurt.
Could be a dead man.
I'm gonna get him.
We ain't your enemies. We your friends.
I don't believe you.
Focus on business.
I gotta get back on top.
Hey yo, it's DJ Caesar. Check me out each and every Saturday morning, 10 a.m. to 12 noon on Shade 45 Sirius XM. Weekend Word, Coach PR, DJ Caesar.
Weekend Word, one motherfucking Shade 45, nigga.